Check one. Check one. Check two. And we are live. I'll let you touch and I'll let you see. I'll let you taste and I'll let you feel. All that you love and all that you hate, all you distrust, all you say, everything under the sun is in tune, but the sun is eclipsed by the moon. Yeah, solar eclipse. That's a butcher job of Pink Floyd's. You can't play the songs because we live in an age now of people, of artists that want to be paid for you to play their music. Or you don't play it. We'll take it from you, man. But anyway, great song. Talking about the, not talking about music, censorship in music today. We're talking about the total eclipse of the sun that happens every so often if you're standing in the right spot. I guess it always happens on Earth. It's just you don't always see it. It's when the moon, right? The sun is way out there. And if you don't know what a solar eclipse is, I'll tell you what it is. And this way you can tell your friends that you know what it is. Hell yeah, this is a fucking eclipse, people say. They don't know exactly what it is. It's when the moon, right? The sun is out there, right? Big sun. And the moon is closer to us and it's passing, right? And it passes directly in front of the sun. Right? Now, the sun is huge, but it's far away. And the moon, because it's close and it's a perfect circle, it blots out the sun. And for that moment in broad daylight, this time it'll happen in broad daylight between 12 and 3 p.m. in the United States, Eastern Time, there'll be almost a total blackout. Now, I've seen them before. I remember when one passed through New York City, and it didn't get dark. It was more like a brownout, right? Like everything got very hazy for a minute, right? And yellow. That was the biggest characteristic I remember of the total eclipse was a sense of yellow. Hold on a second. I really got to get a music clip, a music stand, because I'm gonna. I dropped this guitar too many times. That's actually not a bad place to put a guitar, laying it flat on the floor with the strings down, right? Because as long as you're the only one in the room and you don't step on it, it's safe that way. The guitar is the strings are on the ground and they're not. There's no chance of it falling, right? Anyway, welcome everybody. Welcome in the chat. Welcome, Vinny Martini. What's up, Vinny? Vinny gave us a great clip because with solar eclipses, right, any major event in the world also is grounds for theories, conspiracies of we might get attacked. Why April 8? The significance in the number 8 and April and 8. And then this is the time the deep state is going to step in and kill us all and choke us and cause earthquakes. Remember Taiwan? I don't know. I mean, is it coincidental? I know everybody's minds. I think it's not coincidental that everybody's minds are firing up when something like this happens, a total eclipse, and you see it, and you maybe I don't know. It has. I imagine it has for even regular, you know, normal people that don't fucking care about the stars or even know they're up there, right? It definitely has a effect because you look up and you see, like, well, the moon is in front of the sun and everything is dark and it's 12 o'clock in the afternoon And it's mystical, right? There's a mystical mysticism to eclipses, regardless of, you know, what, it's just the position of the planets. Now, will the planets be affected by that? Does plant life and the tides on Earth and everything else, is it truly affected by a total eclipse? Probably not. It's just a moment of darkness. It could be a shadow to a plant. It's no big deal, I don't think. But other people think it is. It has a big effect on humans. Humans launch into a conspiracy of sorts. So we'll look at that. They're fascinating, right? Planet Earth, right? We're citizens of planet Earth, right? Whether we like it or not. It's not like you can revoke your citizenship to planet Earth. You're here and you got to deal with it at least until you're dead. Right. And if you had kids, then, you live on, right? You live on through your kids. Right. We're here and we're citizens of Earth, and we're going to see this fascinating event. Hopefully you're in the line of it and you can go stand out in front of it. I personally am not. It would require a bit of a drive, a few hours onto the New York side to all the way up north to Niagara Falls. We'll look at the map. I'll tell you where it is, where the eclipse is going to happen. Maybe it's in your neck of the woods and you get to see it and firsthand. I'm sure there'll be, we live in the age of a million cameras. But I don't think any camera can capture that moment when the sun blots out, when the moon blots out the sun. Completely, right? Fucking spiritual, right? And for 4 minutes, it can go. It's only a 4-minute event. Right? That's pretty long, too. That's pretty long. So we'll look at this fascinating event. Welcome everybody in the chat. Vinny Martini, William R. Hall. I think you're going to get some eclipse up there in Syracuse. It looks like you might be in the line of fire. To see it. Thomas Robinson, what's up? John R. in the house. David Brown is here. William Smith, Orange, Champ, City. Facet Pay Fines is doing some lurking today. Good morning, good morning. Weevil Girl in the house. Weevil on the Wrench. Spirit Child is here as well. Everybody, thank you very much. Thank you very much for joining me, and thank yourself for joining you. And been doing a lot of meditating. I think the eclipse is a good time to meditate. And I think that eyes open. No, don't close your eyes. Sit quietly and observe it and see if there's any communication. Open up a channel when you're sitting under the eclipse. You open up a channel. You say, I'm open. You do something like that, right? And you open up to the eclipse, and you report for yourself if anything changes. Right? Right? Maybe that's what we have to do. Maybe everybody, it's a meditative moment. It's my thumbnail. Total eclipse 2024. We're dealing with a total eclipse of the sun. When the sun is in tune and the sun is eclipsed by the moon. Got the Pink Floyd song jammed in my head. What else is happening? Also, massive hockey fight here on Earth. Rangers and Devils. Rangers, New York. Devils, New Jersey. Neighbors beating the shit out of each other on the opening bell. Of a Ranger game. We'll take a look at that. It's always good to watch a good hockey fight. And people complaining on Earth that they don't have enough money. Meanwhile, brokers on Wall Street are walking away because they're only getting $100,000 a year. Or, excuse me, getting $100,000 a year. And to them, that's not enough. Excuse me. It's not enough. I only have $100,000. I need more to live. Damn it! So we'll look at the money woes of Wall Street. There's an island for sale in Fort Florida somewhere, Fort fucking something, right? It's inland. It's in a bay. I'm thinking about buying it. I may do a GoFundMe. It's only $14 million, right? And you would own, it's called Beer Can Island in Florida. I'd like to buy it and turn it into a meditation retreat. Get rid of all of the beer cans. I don't know why it has the name Beer Can Island. First thing you do is get rid of the beer cans, and you erect the largest Buddha in the world on the island. Make it fucking, I don't know, how big is the biggest Buddha on the planet? Let's, you do the research. Maybe, I don't know, like you want it the size of the fucking Freedom Tower. Giant fucking Buddha looking out over Florida, Tampa Bay. That's what it is. Not Fort, Tampa Bay in the Bay. Well, look at the map. And so island for sale. Maybe I'll do a GoFundMe and we'll move the program to Beer Can Island in fucking Tampa. So there you go. Weevil Girl says, stop taking life for granted. Amen to that. Amen to that. Life is precious, and it's really short, right? You got this one time where you pass through, and you got arms and legs and eyes and ears and a nose and tongue and mouth to make sounds, right? You got this one opportunity, right? You may think it goes on forever in your mind, right? Or you're busy worrying about what's happening right now. Like, oh, fucking, I hate this fucking life, man. Life sucks, man. Why do I have to do this when I want to be doing that? How come I can't have a Learjet? How come I can't be a billionaire with a Learjet? Or something like that, right? We're all worried. And then we realize the guy with the Learjet doesn't have much more than we do, right? In fact, he, in many respects, he starts to have less because he takes himself out of nature, even if he's flying over it in a fucking Learjet. So I got a website. It's every morning at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time here in the United States of America. It's educational, philosophical. I don't claim to know anything in particular. I have no expertise in on anything other than myself. Everything here is on this morning program is really just my opinion and the fine people that come and join me every morning. This is our opinion and nothing more. This could never be construed as, I don't know, not even, it's not even news. Like, I'm not talking about news. I'm flipping the fucking newspaper and seeing what's going on. So anyway, every morning at 9 a.m., you get some good insights here. You get to really, really, really know your world philosophically and educationally. Right? And if you miss it, we're live right now. This is live broadcast. These are live people. If you want to join us, 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time in the U.S., come join us, jump into the chat, and contribute, right? Contribute. Don't be a dick. Don't be a dick, because we don't like that. So live on YouTube, or you can just watch across all of these platforms. We're on all of them. You can make a contribution through Zelle and PayPal and Patreon. The case of get your white privilege out of here, exclusive to this channel, where once upon a time a reporter got attacked verbally and racially verbally attacked while he was doing his job and kicked off the property of a hospital. Come over here and watch the video and you'll learn more about it. The case is heating up. It's now 4 years old, but we're going to trial. We're going to trial. We're going to trial. Brooklyn Hospital, get your papers ready because we're taking you to court. Right, we're taking you down. Right. Hey, look, in a case like this, right, there's no, if they want to settle, if Brooklyn Hospital Center wants to settle, they can at this point walk away with no admission of guilt, no record of any of these events, and it can move right along. But if they want to be dickheads and they want to challenge the amount, the settlements and such, and be jerk-off lawyers, well, then you're going to go to court and you're going to lose because your guy, Brooklyn Hospital, is a racist, right? Mr. fucking in the video guy with evidence, is a racist, right? He's working in your hospital, and he's a devout racist, kicking people off the property with the words, get your white privilege out of here. Now, you want to go to the New York State Division of Human Rights hearing, and you want to defend this cracker? You want to defend this idiot? Right? Because that's what you're going to do, right? Brooklyn Hospital Center. You're going to, you're defending a fat, racist idiot. Right. And saying that somehow justifying his actions as okay. Right. Is that what you want to do? Is that what you want to go on the record, or you want to get out of this? Right. That's what you need to think about. Lawyers, think about it. Brooklyn Hospital Center, because in the final analysis, if you lose in court, and you will lose. You know, now there's a huge giant record of your establishment being racist. And people are going to line up to get you, right? They're going to, because you're a fucking, because you, you can't admit a fault. Right? So digest that for a while. Marcus Conte reporting. So so let's talk about, I'm sorry for people in the chat. That had that was a direct message to my detractors. So here we go. Interstates in the path of the total solar eclipse, April 8th. Damn, April 8th. April 8th is right around the corner. This broadcast is happening April 4th. So you could see the line. This is a great line, whoever did this, right? And you can see the various intersections that you can drive up to see it. But it goes, it's going to do a sweep. The solar eclipse will sweep from Texas down, all the way down at the tip of Texas. Where I believe it connects to Mexico. Where's Mexico? They fucking took Mexico out of the picture. Mexico, it goes from through Mexico, skips over the Gulf all the way up through the southern states. I my geography is horrible. I can't, without the names of the states behind it, I don't know which states these are, but it goes all the way up, man. Ohio's going to get it, parts of Pennsylvania, where I am going to get it, but very close on the tip. I'm closer to New York City. I'm closer to the other side of Pennsylvania, and on the border there. But the top of New York is going to get it up here in the East Coast. Looks like half of Vermont, half of what is this? I guess Massachusetts and Maine. Right? So big line of states, they're already talking about traffic jams and craziness, right? So maybe the conspiracy theory people are right, that people lose their fucking minds in a solar eclipse. So so it looks like this is our earthquake, people. This is our Taiwan had an earthquake, but we're going to have an eclipse. Let's get back to that, but let's watch the hockey fight, right? So it's already happening here on Earth. See, craziness, right? There's an eclipse coming, and the Rangers and the Devils face off at Madison Square Garden, and they forget that they're playing hockey, and they start punching each other. Watch. All right, here we go. Boom, bang. Huh, what is that? Get out of the way. So here's the hockey fight. Good hockey fight. I love a good hockey fight. There's a better angle of it. The two guys up here, those are the stars of the fight, because those are the big fighters. But you see, you got five fights going on at once. Everybody's just punching each other. It's fucking crazy, man. Ah, the beautiful game, right? Now, you say to yourself, well, this isn't a sport, is it? It's fucking, they're animals. They're fighting and hey, listen, there's a rich tradition of aggression in hockey, right? And sometimes they throw punches, right? And it's all okay. You get a 5-minute penalty. If you really hurt the guy, then you get 4-game suspension. you could beat him up a little bit, but if you really hurt him, you get 4 games. Otherwise, it's just 5 minutes in the box. So these are the two star punchers. That's hard, man. They've been punching each other now for about 2 minutes. No, not that long. So big hockey fight. Here's a better angle. Let's watch this angle. Oh, this fucking angle. There we go. Boom. Get a little more action. So that's the main guy. This guy on the Rangers. These are big guys. These are both of these guys are 6'8". they're really fucking tall men, right? And they're in their 20s, and you don't want to get punched in the face by one of them, right? But I was saying, in hockey, there's a rich history of fighting, and it's very manly. Maybe that's why women, right? Women, hey, women, you want to be in the game? One of these guys will punch you in their face, punch you in the face, right? And it's all okay. If you don't like it, don't get in the game. Right? Don't get in the game. Right? Because these guys will kick your ass. Any one of them will kick your ass, ladies. Oh man, Rompey, that's his name, right? He's a rookie too, fucking rookie. I'll fight anybody. That's his claim to fame. The Rangers have a history of getting guys like that. I'll fight anybody, right? One more time. If sports, the world of sports wants to stop. Let me shut this shit off. If the world of sports wants to stop fighting in hockey, it's very simple. If you fight, you're suspended for the season. You're out. You have one fight and it's over. This guy's strong, man. The Devil's guy was really beating the shit out of him. Man. If you wanted to get rid of fighting in hockey, it's not hard to do. You just have to. Well, these guys got kicked out of the game. Yeah, man. There he is. Rompey, he's a bloody mess, that guy, right? He's usually got black eyes. So that's the hockey fight, a big hockey fight. Pretty pleased with Sugar. Never take fighting out of hockey because it's one and the same, right? Spirit Child says, hockey players are definitely tough dudes, grabbing shirts for leverage and beating each other bare knuckles. Yeah, man. Punching helmets too, right? They leave their helmets on. You punch somebody in the face, that hurts. It hurts them and it hurts you. But if you punch somebody's helmet, it hurts you. Right? Break a knuckle like that. Right? I don't know, man. I would wear gloves under my gloves, right? Because they drop the gloves, right? They have good gloves. Hockey players have great gloves. But when they fight, they drop the gloves because it's not fair to punch somebody with a hockey glove. You know what it is about the hockey glove? It has a very sharp thumb. The thumb sticks out, and it's like a plastic. So it's like a blunt end. Maybe that's why, because you can knock somebody's eye out with it. Right? But they drop the gloves. You see them always. They drop the gloves. They drop this. No sticks, no gloves, just bare knuckle fucking brawling. So quickly, and then we'll get into the Eclipse. Junior brokers, and also the market. The market will open in a minute or so. Junior brokers say they'll quit after bonuses fall. But top 1%, 0.1% celebrate soaring market and plunging private jet costs. Could you imagine celebrating? Oh, look, our private jet costs. It used to cost $12,000 an hour. Now it's only $8,000 an hour. Hey, honey, have you heard the news? We can fly more. So while everybody in America is basically living in a sense of abject poverty, right? You're squeaking by, man. You're just getting by. Right? Most people are just getting by. And these clowns on Wall Street are complaining that $176,500 is fucked up as compared to $180,000 last year, a 2% decline in my pay. Now, that is a lot of money for one person to have. Even if you're in New York City, that is a lot of money. You don't have to spend $40,000 a year on rent. You don't have to do that. You can go into the suburbs and get $1,000 a month rent. For 12 grand, you can live all year round and you made $176,000. And you don't have to sit down in expensive restaurants every night. Food, the cost and the price of food, raw, supermarket food in New York City is the same or less than it is anywhere else in the country. So there's no reason for that. There's no reason to complain, is my point. But they're complaining. Why? Because, look, Carbone, right, the fucking restaurant down in the West Village, Carbone, is charging almost $100 for dinner, right? Right, one fucking dinner, $100, right? You want dinner, $100, right? And you want a glass of champagne, $95 for Dom Perignon, right? $60 for Ornelia, I don't know what that is. But Dom Perignon, $100. You can buy the whole bottle for $100. Or you can buy, you know, that's good champagne, though. That's good champagne. It's right from France. But you see the prices people are paying. Look at this, fucking $95. A dinner tab can quickly balloon to $300 or more, and drinks can go up $100. So that's why they're complaining. They're not making enough money because they can't afford Dom Perignon at $100 a glass, right? That's what they're complaining about. That's what people in New York City, the broker class, they're complaining, I can't have $100 glass of champagne every night and maybe two or three. How fucking uncivilized this place has become. I can't dine at Il Carbano every single night and eat the fucking best food in the world. What's going on with this? What's going on with the planet? It must be the eclipse. Anyway, but first year in place, so this is just a stupid story, really, about people. Stop complaining, man. Stop complaining. You're living in a great city, New York, right? Fucking, yeah, stop complaining, right? You don't need that much money, right? Give it back a little bit. Give it back. But they're complaining. I want to buy this island. I really do. This fucking island, 14.2 million. Beer Can Island, right? Look at this island, right? Now, this is a sweet island. Forget about the name. Forget about the history of it. Forget about the negativity that seems to be surrounding it. The beer cans, right? But look at this beautiful island. Look at this private beach all the way around. You got some pine trees here. You could do you got to chop down trees and fucking humans. Right? You got to chop it down, man. Where am I going to build my house? I can't live outside. I'm a fucking human. But there's the island. Where is it? There it is. Where's the island? So it's in Florida, right? I thought it was off the coast somewhere in some, you know, beautiful fucking tropical ocean. But really, it's not. It's in the bay. Right? It's deep in the bay of Tampa. Right? Surrounded by human civilization. This is dirty water, right? Where is it? There it is. It's right here. Let's see it. Beer Can Island, there it is, Pine Key, Tampa Bay. That's what. It is. So on this image, they have some makeshift tents or whatever built right on the beach. It's about a mile away. Right, you live a mile. This would be great, right? You have your own boat, and it's only a mile. Right? You can get a jet ski. Jet ski get you a mile in fucking 5 minutes. You'd be on, you're on the mainland in 5 minutes, right? And you just dock on the beach, wherever this is, right? You park right here, you get out, you walk to fucking 7-Eleven or wherever else you're trying to go. And you're good to go, right? But anyway, man, island for sale. Why am I talking about it? I don't know. It just shows you, you know, $14 million. This really, people have $14 million. Why does one person have to get the island? Why not open it up? Why not make a park out of it? Why not build a boardwalk out to it, or, you know, or have a ship go out there and take people out at 9 a.m. and hang out, and 5 p.m. you ring the bell and everybody gets back on the boat. Anyway, so let's talk about the eclipse. This is fascinating time. Fascinating time to see an eclipse. Mark Scotty reporting on the solar eclipse, the magnificent, amazing solar eclipse. It's like having 20 or 30 Super Bowls happening all at once. That's bullshit. I'm not buying that, right? Fucking stop fear-mongering people into moving into position to see the solar eclipse. It's like 20 Super Bowls. Nobody fucking cares about the Super Bowl. Americans and tourists from far and wide will be heading towards the path of totality. across the U.S. in advance of the upcoming solar eclipse. Solar eclipse, yeah. But travelers should pack their patience because traffic jams are expected. 15 states are in the path of totality from Texas to Maine. A traffic nightmare that will have a widespread impact on at least 30 interstates. Leave early, right? Whatever. Just get leave early and stay late. Right? Don't fucking, the second you see it, oh, right, we saw it, let's go. Savor it a bit, you know, hang out. Right? Spend the night, spend the day or two. Right? Sleep in the car if you have to. Right? Having a total solar, having a total solar eclipse pass through the U.S., it's kind of like having 20 or 30 Super Bowls all at once. Again, with this nonsense about the Super Bowl. So many people are gathering for the spectacle over a long distance. That's a good image right there. That's kind of what I recall seeing. It wasn't a blackout. It was a brownout, and then it was yellow. Right? It was so mysterious. I can't wait to hear people experience it. Right, this time, pay attention and be in it, and you'll all of a sudden it's just. I remember it in New York; everything stopped too. Humanity stopped because it was a solar eclipse. But there was more to it, is what I'm trying to say. Suddenly, everything, it's busy New York; it's lunchtime, shit is buzzing around, and all of a sudden, the planet it's getting darker, and it's still the middle of the day. And then it's like gold, right? Like this gold, you're on a gold planet. It's like you're on a different planet for a moment because you've never seen anything like it. And you can look up and see it. And you can see the sun just blotting. You could see the moon just right in front of the sun with a little ring around it. A little ring of sun around the moon. It's fascinating, right? Black spot. Right? But that's what it looks like. I do recall what it felt like. As I said, it caused people to stop for a moment. They stopped, and they were almost like how did I get here? You know, they were looking at the sun, and they were looking at each other for a minute, and it was quiet. Nobody beeping, nobody racing around. Right. So it definitely has some sort of sedating effect. So what else can we find out about this fucking thing? 15 states are in the path. I know, we know that. About 31.9 million people live in the path of totality. Ohio alone is expecting anywhere from 150 to 500,000 visitors. That's a good thing. That's a good thing when humans move around in their own country. Stop worrying about it. Stop fear-mongering. Let people get in their cars and drive and see each other and experience a natural phenomena together instead of alone in isolation, looking out their own window. God damn it. Arkansas is in the line. Texas, expecting a million out-of-state people. Niagara Falls has already declared a state of emergency. They're expecting a million visitors to Niagara Falls. That's like a Woodstock. Right? Woodstock. Everybody, it's great. This is great. Right? Everybody's interested. Why are people suddenly interested in the eclipse? It is a good question. I don't ever remember this being such, but it is. So there's advisories. And don't travel. Fuck you. If all 5 million visitors leave shortly after the total eclipse ends, which will last for more than 4 minutes, it would be equivalent to 71 football games ending at once. All right. Point taken. Don't go enjoy or where you are enjoy and film. Make sure you film it. And then leave. Leave later. Smoky Mountains in Virginia. It should have taken us about 6 to 7. So more about the travel. They're so engulfed in this travel thing. So that's really all I have on it. I don't have much. Oh, here's a conspiracy theory guy. We'll watch that guy in a second. But I want to click to the market. Ding, we're open. Ding, we're open. And what do we got? What do we got? What do we got? What do we got? All right. So markets. I'm watching Reddit right now. It's down 31 cents. Go up, man. Go uppy. It was 47 a second ago. So Nasdaq. Wow, good. Nasdaq up 161. That's nice. Dow Jones Industrial Average up 283. S&P 500 up 42. And I know people look at a lot of different things in the market. I get that. I tend to look at the high tech. If you don't like that, then you can look somewhere else. But Reddit, or I'll try to talk about other things. The Dow is, you know, the Dow encompasses a lot of other stocks. On the IPO board, Reddit is down 27 cents. Trump is down 89 cents this morning. Rivian, not an IPO, but a former IPO, 10.50 a share. Tesla down. And on the big board, NVIDIA, again, leading the technology charge, up $13 today. Google down a dollar. Apple up a dollar. Amazon down two. Meta up 15. Oh, my God. Facebook up another $15 to $521. Microsoft also following up $5 a share. On the Bitcoin watch, up another $14,000. $14,000, Bitcoin is up today. Some of these people that bought it at a dollar, they should go buy fucking Beer Can Island, right? Give it back. Anybody who made millions and millions of dollars in Bitcoin needs to go buy Beer Can fucking Island and get rid of the beer cans and build the biggest Buddha statue in the world. The biggest. I do mean the biggest. That would be great for America. That's my dream. My dream before I die is to build or be involved in the building of the greatest, largest Buddha statue in the world, right? And it's in America, right? Fucking America. Steal that opportunity, man. Espresso, thank you. Yeah. So, what was I talking about? I forgot. Oh yeah, Moderna. The Johnson & Johnson, Moderna, Pfizer are all, they're mixed. So in a sense, in summation, the market, NASDAQ is up 162, Dow down 283, S&P 542. There you go, man. So let's look at this conspiracy surrounding. We've heard everything we basically want to hear about the eclipse, where and when and such. And did we really hear that, when and where? Let me just reiterate. If you wanted to see it, because that's why you came here to watch it, right? To know about it. It's going to be. I forgot what I was going to say. Oh, yeah, here's the times, right? Between 1:40 p.m., if you're in the line of fire, it's going to be different everywhere you are. That's the point, right? It's going to start around 1:40, and it'll end at around 3:30 up there in Maine. Cleveland is going to get it. So check the times. Check your local times. That's the map one last time. And if you're by one of these intersections, I'm by 81. If I just drove 81, I would hit it eventually. But it's a long ride. It's all the way up to Buffalo. I'm not going to fucking Buffalo. See no moon. So let's listen to this guy.
Eclipse on April 8th is becoming a major event. The National Guard is being deployed, and the people are being advised. The solar eclipse on April 8th is becoming a major event. The National Guard is being deployed, and the people are being advised to have 2 weeks of food and to fill their fuel tanks. This could all be explained due to the fact that tens of thousands of visitors are expected along the path of totality. But many people believe that they could be prepared.
The path of totality. That's so dark, man. It's fucking dark. The path, all the people in the path of totality. Right. Is there anything to see here? Let's continue.
Preparing for possible earthquakes due to the Devil Comet aligning with the April 8th eclipse.
The Devil Comet. Right? I'm laughing with him. I don't know. He could be right. He could be. That's why we watch. Adding to the growing excitement around the eclipse is the return of Comet 12P PONS Brooks, also known as the Devil Comet. The Devil Comet. The comet's name derives from its horn-like appearance. So it's a Devil Comet.
And due to the fact that in 1811, a comet also appeared in the skies during a solar eclipse on the same path and was followed by the biggest earthquakes in American history.
Oh, okay.
Major earthquake has struck off the coast.
That's possible, right? Does the eclipse have anything to do with earthquakes? Excuse me, I'll say that again. I've been stumbling my words. It's a teeth problem. Well, maybe it's a brain problem. Does the solar eclipse have anything whatsoever to do with the fucking earthquakes? Solar eclipse, earthquakes. Is there a connection to those two things? Well, in the sense that they're natural occurrences, that's about it. Is it a sign that more... Look, both... The reality is this. An earthquake... Although it's scary if you're standing on top of it, it's actually quite a beautiful thing. It's an amazing event that shows everything below you is in flux. It's not solid like you think it is. It's only solid for a moment, and it's moving. And you look up at the sun and you realize that things do align very predictably too. Right? This is 100% predictable. They know exactly when the sun is going to get blotted out. In terms of earthquakes, that's a little harder to predict. I don't know why that is. I'm not really sure. Maybe it actually says that the planet is more unstable than space itself, or more unpredictable. Right? What's under us is more unpredictable than what's above us. Right? That's kind of an assessment. But are the two things working in consort? I don't know.
Coast of southwestern Japan. It's a magnitude 7.5.
All right, just want to bring you an update on the earthquake near Taiwan.
Orange man says, excuse me, Mama always said never look into the sun, the heart of the sun. That's a good point, right? People are going to be staring at the sun. I do it. I confess. I stare right at the sun for about a second or two or three. And I got to tell you, it actually feels like it corrects my eyeballs a little bit. Sometimes early in the morning when the sun just comes up, not when it's high noon, but when it just comes up and you could see it and it's round and it's orange, right? You just kind of hold your gaze there a little bit when it's clear, no clouds, and you could see it and you could feel it. And you could feel the sun, right? You could feel it's not only feeling the heat, the radiation on your body, but your eyeballs detect it because it's very powerful. It's very strong. Right? But I would say that is a problem. If you're going to go to watch the eclipse and you're going to keep looking at the sun until it eclipses, right? You put in an hour of staring at the sun and then it eclipses and you put in another 4 minutes. That's too much time staring at the sun. Now, I know they have glasses for that. But you generally don't want to get a filter between you and what you're seeing. You don't want that. You want raw, naked eyeball to see it, to experience it completely, fully. You see it, and there it is, and there's no lenses. Take your glasses off. You don't need them. You don't need glasses to see this event. Right? Whatever strength your eyes are, you'll see it. Right? But don't hurt yourself is the point I'm trying to make. Don't deliberately stare And don't stare at the sun deliberately. And don't go telling people, oh, I watched this jerk off online. This fucking guy said, you got to hold your gaze because it's good for you. Don't say that either. But anyway, stare directly at the sun. I got no problem with that.
7.5 magnitude earthquake happened.
Those guys trying to whip the two together. Let's see if he can do it. He's talking about the Taiwan earthquake and the upcoming fucking eclipse.
21 kilometers southeast of Hualien City in Taiwan. This is according to the U.S. Geological Survey. Very strong shaking at magnitude strength.
All right, speed it up.
It was felt widely in the Taiwanese capital, Taipei.
Speed it up, Jerky.
A tsunami warning has also been issued for a number of those small Japanese islands that you see there just to the northeast of Taiwan. Also, tsunami waves as high as...
measured at 8.8 magnitude.
They
were the most measured earthquakes.
Strange
story. Around 10,000 earthquakes occurred in just 3 months' time, the biggest being measured at 8.8 magnitude. They were the most...
Wait a second. During the pioneers' time, three earthquakes shook the remote settlement of New Madrid, Missouri. Really? From 1811 to 1812, these earthquakes were some of the strongest ever experienced on the continent, only beaten by magnitude 9.2 quake that leveled Alaska. 9.2, that is fucking death, right? The one in Hualien, Taiwan, was 7.2 to 7.4. It was different. They got it as high as 7.4. But if you add another 2 points to that, that levels everything. Everything, every building goes up and comes crumbling down. Right? There's no surviving 9.2. Or maybe there is. What do I know? It's fucking everybody's still alive at 7.4.
Devastating series of earthquakes.
I did not know that. I did not know that there was that these. I don't know if it's true or not. If you guys want to fact check it, but it's fascinating. 1964, Anchorage, Alaska, 9.2 earthquake.
In recorded history, this eclipse season is, however, a very rare event. The recent eclipses in August of 2017 and October of 2023, along with the upcoming one on April 8th, forms an Aleph and a Tav over the United States. The Aleph and Tav are the first and last letters of the Hebrew alphabet.
Okay, so now he's going to blame the Jews.
The Hebrew alphabet.
Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. These eclipses mark the end of the great year, a 26,000-year period that starts anew with the dawning of Aquarius and a new golden age.
I'm sorry, man. I can't go down this rabbit hole with the guy. This is a rabbit hole. It's a good rabbit hole. It's a fun rabbit hole. Anonymous official, congratulations. Great. A great clip. 107,000 views in 17 hours. Good job, man. I don't know. I'm not swallowing it. I can't, maybe I'm too fucking shallow, right, to see it. Right? I can't see the connection because I'm too human. So.
Manly
I just
P.
don't
Hall
see it.
Wrote that high level Masons designed America for a peculiar and particular purpose.
And they always say that there's a bunch of humans, responsible for it. Right? The humans, they're causing it. They're doing it. They're blotting out the sun. Don't look at it. It's a trap. It's a trap.
A secret.
The earth is flat. You're looking at a light bulb. It's Hollywood, man.
Destiny to bring about a new Atlantis or a new world order, wherein a king descended of a divine race will rule over all.
That's like biblical. These guys getting into biblical.
In rituals, this king is symbolized as Apollo, Horus, or Nimrod, the father of Freemasonry, and is thought...
Vinny, I'm sorry, Vinny. I'm shitting on your video. Vinny brought this to my attention. I didn't really watch it. I'm just watching it now with you guys. I'm just saying overall, it's an interesting clip, right, where he's trying to draw connections to the solar eclipse and other types of destruction on Earth. Now, I just told you, by staring at the solar eclipse, it does have an effect on humans. I felt it had a calming effect, right? But maybe not. Maybe it's a trigger, right? Maybe the solar eclipse is a trigger for humans. And then they go out and they want to rule the world, right? They see their smallness and their brief moment on Earth, and they want to go out and eat other people, I guess. I don't know.
To be a descendant of the biblical Nephilim or the Sumerian Anunnaki. According to Thomas Horn, this will happen in 2025.
All right, I'm done with this guy, man. Peace, man. This is good stuff, man. Good stuff. The eclipse is coming. The eclipse is coming. And that's the way it is, man. Thank you all for joining me. Where's my guitar? Happy Thursday to you. Oh, it's Thursday. It's Thursday. I'll see you guys on Monday. When is the eclipse, by the way? When is the eclipse? Monday? The eclipse is Monday. So we'll be here. I'll be here live. And we'll be here Monday morning for the big eclipse. The big solar eclipse. When the sun blots out. When the moon blots out the sun. Where will you be? Will everything on Earth change? What will become of me? Peace, everybody. Marcus Conte reporting. Try to do some solar songs. Don't take away my sun. I need to see you all the time. Why is it so dark in here? Don't take away my sun. There you go. Don't take away my sun. So dark in here. Oh, oh, oh.